For a change, probably we will not talk about the subject to start with. I'll ask you a question. Who is the actor in movie Devadas? Shahrukh Khan, anybody want to differ? Yes. So there are two point of view. One group says that it is Devadas, and another group says another different actor. What is the reason? The different time, no? See, whenever we think of Devadas, the oldest story, 1900, somebody wrote, and 72 times the movie was made in different languages. So whenever we think it is Devadas, same Shahrukh Khan is the last 2011. 2018, it is a different Devadas. It's a different story, Hindi story came. So what is the most important specific information we needed here, the examiner needed here is the year. You should have asked me which year movie you are asking. So if examiner is now asking something, if you are not able to understand, have guts to talk to him. Ask him the next question. I don't understand. Please repeat the question. That is the most important one. Definitely we are not lions or tigers. We have our kids studying. No? So definitely we are not animals. We are really humans. And we want to help you. Only thing, you worsen the thing by having a blank look. That is the problem. So ask the examiner if you don't have. And the reason I specifically asked this example is, collect as many information as possible before you make a diagnosis in uveitis. Everybody was telling about history, history, history. No, it starts from the time the patient is starting to walking into your clinic. You are going to observe everything. So the way he walks, and there are several things that you will know that we will be seeing now. How we are going to collect information, pieces of information, that will beautifully describe the patient. Now, if you want me to describe, there is a beautiful lady on the dais who is the chief instructor, then there is only one person. Because specific information is given already. No? So we will see how it goes here. Specific information is sclera and episclera is so specific. Only in rheumatoid arthritis, you'll be given cases of rheumatoid arthritis, and it never causes uveitis. It causes only scleritis, episcleritis. Most of the collagen vascular disease, only episcleritis, scleritis. If at all, if you come to anterior uveitis, there are certain conditions that causes anterior uveitis. People blame that uveitis is non-specific. No, it is too specific. We call it idiopathic. But only we are idiots. We don't understand, and we call the uveitis as idiopathic. Okay, this is really true. Only certain things can cause iritis. And only certain disease can cause choroiditis. Like tuberculosis, always cause choroiditis. If it is toxoplasmosis, it is always retinitis. So there are very, very, very specific things, and specific cases will be given to you. If you collect the information, then it is very easy. How to differentiate is scleritis, episcleritis. There are 4 points which you know from the textbook. But I'll give you add 5th point, which is very important practically. See, if you see in between the vessels, if you see the sclera white, it is episcleritis. If you see sclera inflamed, it will be seen like this. In between the vessels, it will be red. So that is, practically this is more important than all your 4 points which you usually muck up and tell. So nodular scleritis and diffuse scleritis and posterior scleritis. Just to cover few points in scleritis. 10 minutes is absolutely not enough for anything, but still we'll go through few points. So there are several tests. See, usually people say rheumatoid arthritis negative in uveitis. Uveitis never seen in rheumatoid arthritis. This is a different set of investigation for scleritis, episcleritis, different set of investigation in uveitis. What do we do? As I told you, the clinical workup starts as the patient starts coming in and then completed with your slit lamp and inner endophthalmoscope. As the patient started coming, you have description, and as the patient started talking, you have few more information. So the history, and then with your slit lamp and indirect, you have certain other points that is called naming. Clinical description is naming. Then you are comparing with the existing literature, that is called meshing. So you name an entity and mesh and see the literature. When you are comfortable with the literature, you will have list of differential diagnosis. By doing naming and meshing, you will have differential diagnosis. With the help of lab investigation, probably you will make a diagnosis. So I am going to tell, this patient has started walking inside my clinic. I have at least two information. Middle age, lady patient, female patient. So two information as I start seeing her. And she is finding it very difficult to walk, and she comes and sits in front of this slit lamp, and she starts telling, I have lost vision in both eyes. By chance, if she says, bilateral, loss of vision is severity and it is acute. She says, for past 2 days, I am not able to see. See, I am just telling this way the patient says, so I am not able to see in both eyes for past 2 days. Then you have, she has just talked and you have five information. Most important five information. Then you are going to see it is like age, gender, laterality, because she has told both eyes and she has told only 2 days, and severity is loss of vision. So you have five information. Then comes your slit lamp. This will tell you whether it is anterior, posterior or panuveitis. And by chance, I have already finished this and this. So I have found out that it is bilateral granulomatous panuveitis with exudative RD. Still it is not enough to make a definitive diagnosis. I do some systemic examination. Even though it is normal, being normal is extremely important to rule out some diseases. So here is the name, 55-year-old lady. We are just adding this information, and this is clinical description. Only one secret. Only up to this point you are expected to talk in the exam. You need not give definitive diagnosis at all. You are going to give differential diagnosis in uveitis, always differential diagnosis. So you just say this, bilateral granulomatous panuveitis with exudative RD in a middle-aged lady. I will give differential diagnosis. So that's it. So now you know pretty well it is only either VKH, sympathetic ophthalmia, sarcoid or TB. Because it is granulomatous and bilateral. And even now you can rule out sympathetic because I have never talked about injury or trauma. So then comes certain test which says normal systemic workup. So sarcoid and TB is ruled out. And you have thick uvea and your FFA finding to tell that it's only VKH. So it's very, very, very simple if you collect clinical description properly. But pieces of information will never help you. Three information in pieces will not help. Three altogether, it will be like a gearbox. Each in a gearbox, each piece is important. Even if you miss one piece, if I am not telling you that it is 2018, and you knew the Avadas will not be even known. So you are collecting everything and you don't spend money at all. It's only few minutes and you can make a diagnosis of VKH. I tell you, in 2 minutes you can make a diagnosis. Focal retinitis, my time is up.
You have 1 minute, ma'am.
Yeah. Focal retinitis with hemorrhage, CMD, focal retinitis with the skeel discar, toxoplasmosis. Diffuse retinitis with the vitreous cells, ARN. Diffuse retinitis without vitreous cells, PON. Retinitis with vasculitis, white lesion with vasculitis is retinitis. White lesion crossing over vessel is normal is choroiditis. Then comes your vasculitis with mouth ulcer. So all these associated findings will give you the information. Vitreous cells, presence of vitreous cells will give you some information, absence of vitreous cells will give you some information in a child with retinoblastoma. So this I have already mentioned to you, focal retinitis, multifocal retinitis, focal choroiditis and multifocal choroiditis. So it's very, very simple. Collect as much information as possible.